Or next, they're like this one. Hey, how about something good? Cut the averages down, high volatility, maximum fear and confusion.
Sell, sell, sell.
Why don't we take a moment to praise the companies that have consistently made us money, along with their stalwart CEOs. The ones with business models that work, even in the worst case scenario, sky-high oil prices, crimping the consumer, the economy, whatever. Specifically, let's talk about Herbalife, HLF, a network marketing company that sells nutritional supplements and weight management products. I like to think of it as an Avon or Tupperware of the weight loss biz. It's as good as Tupperware. It's much better than Avon. Last night, Herbalife reported a stellar quarter, which caused the stock to soar $7.04 today. Come on, the market was down 100 points. And HLF has now given us an astounding 88% gain since the CEO came on the show in my invitation in November of 2009 at $40. See, Herbalife is not just a play on combating obesity, a huge theme that we can't get enough of here on Mad Money, considering how overweight most Americans are and around the world. This company also gives you exposure to our aging population, because as many generations of baby boomers get older, consuming more and more nutritional supplements to stay healthy. How do you think a 66-year-old man like myself stays this spry? And finally, Herbalife also benefits from high unemployment. Since it's a direct sales company, regular people who are out of work or need a little extra money have a lot more of incentive to become Herbalife's distributors, just like they would throw Tupperware or Avon parties, although they're obviously not doing the latter. That makes this stock a play on not one, not two, but three major themes that we like here on Mad Money. So it's no wonder that Herbalife delivered a superb quarter. Earnings coming in at $1.31 per share, monster 19-cent beat. And while half the beat came from a lower-than-expected tax rate, the other half came from just very strong business. It's Herbalife's time. The company's sales rose 17% year-over-year. Worldwide volumes were up 16.1%. And for the second consecutive quarter, each of the six regions where Herbalife operates, China, Mexico, Asia-Pacific, South and Central America, Europe, the Middle East and Africa, and North America all experienced volume growth. Herbalife also issued upside guidance for the next quarter, and the board approved a two-for-one split, something that we know has zero effect on the numbers, but can also help stoke the animal spirits of the market and make people more eager to buy. Herbalife's made you a ton of money. Okay? Especially because we proudly got behind the CEO at a time when short sellers were making up a lot of bad stuff about the company that we correctly chose to ignore. So let's talk to Michael Johnson, Herbalife's very bankable chairman and CEO, find out more about the quarter and what remains ahead for this terrific company. Mr. Johnson, welcome back to Mad Money.
Hi, Jim. How are you?
Well, I'm pretty darn good. You know why? Because you have made so many people money, and that makes me happy, Michael.
Well, thank you, Jim.
All right, first big question. What the heck are you doing public? If I were you, I would take the company private, demand 33% of the equity, and bring it public six years from now when people recognize your greatness. What do you think of my plan?
Well, I think it's an interesting plan, Jim. If someone comes knocking on the door like you, we'll talk to you.
Well, I'd have to own a Major League Soccer team or something to do that. All right. What's happening? First of all, we got to do some region by region, because as great as the United States was, will you tell me what is happening in Mexico? Because most people don't recognize Mexico as an unbelievable market. You and to some degree Home Depot, by the way, but you're the only guy I've ever seen taking over a country by storm. What the heck is happening there?
Well, in Mexico, this is the birth of our nutrition clubs. It's a place where it all started, the daily consumption model. And we went through a tremendous growth about 3 years ago, $200 to $600 million marketplace. And then it slowed down a bit because we were having a little trouble getting product to the marketplace. So we have a great president of our company, Des Walsh, and a wonderful team there who put together an idea to use a retailer to supply product out into the marketplace. We don't do it through the retail outlet. We use their warehouses and storage areas. It's kind of like an old catalog store. When I was a kid in Michigan, you'd go to the Sears store and you'd pick up your product. It's the same idea. So the product is a way more accessible to our distributors, allowing them to grow their business on a local basis. So these clubs are local in small communities all over the place. We got a great management team down there, and they are hitting it, and the distributors are in concert with us. It's a big, big hit down there.
All right, now, if you have your druthers, Russia or China or Brazil, which would you put the most money on for when I see you next is going to have the greatest rise in business?
Oh, boy. You know, I'm always cautious about China. I love China. I think it's a great marketplace, but we have a government partner there who it's interpretation of the rules sometimes, and so we're going to be a little more cautious about China. We're starting to see some change in the game in Brazil as they adapt the same model they did in Mexico. So maybe Brazil is a growth model, and China is probably an overall long-term bet.
Well, I know that weight management, which is how I now view your company, I view it as a health weight management company, has been red hot. That's what we saw with Weight Watchers. Why is it that your company seems to be so underestimated by people who don't seem to recognize the power of the aging trend, the weight trend, and your incredible model for when people need more money?
Well, I think we're probably operate a little more quietly than them in terms of we're not on, you know, we don't buy television media the way others do because we don't have to. It's a push business where people have their own areas to operate. So they operate in neighborhoods and they reach out to people, and it's a very, very personalized business. We're going to have a much stronger presence on the web very soon. So maybe people will take notice of us a little bit more. But you want to know something? We're just scratching the surface. We're just getting started. So our people in their business model and their business efforts are going to reach out, and you'll know more about us, you know, and you know about us, but the public at large will know more about us, see what we're worth in terms of building a healthier, more opportunistic social network.
Oh, you are doing it. Now, Michael, I also want people to understand more about your business, the way it runs. We care in this show, we know about net sales growth, we know about volume point growth, but there are two other indicators that I want you to talk about. Average active sales leaders, and then how many people stay on as leaders. These are obviously key metrics that people have to understand if they're going to buy the stock.
Jim, those are the two most important pieces of news in our quarterly and annual earnings report. The retention rate in the company, meaning the people who stay with us year after year at a higher level, these are called sales leaders, and they get about a 50% discount on the product. It's almost 50%. It's 48.9%. A decade ago when we came into the company, it was 23%.
Right.
Now, a few changes took place in the way people were allowed to requalify, but the most important thing, and that's the second part of this, is that these people are active. They're continuing on a monthly basis to order and reorder because they're building daily consumption into their business. This is a huge factor for us. That means if you come to Herbalife and become a sales leader in the company, you have a 50% chance, 49% chance to be exact, to stay with us. Now, when you think about businesses that start up, small restaurants, shoe repair places, you've got a 10% chance of survival. Now in Herbalife, it's 50%. We are blown away by this number. We're excited about it. But again, we're just scratching the surface.
All right, one last question, because I know you got to go. How many jobs have you created?
Oh, God. In our company, millions.
Yeah. How many?
Millions.
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 People should talk about you more. Michael Johnson, fabulous quarter, great work. Thank you for making us so much money.
Jim, thanks for your support, too. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. Real deal. Got behind him when everyone else was running. That's one of the ways you make big money. You listen, you see a pro, you see what this guy is doing. He's doing it, and it's going higher. Thank you, Michael Johnson, Chairman and CEO of Herbalife, HLF.